question and probably a difficult question as well. The question says x and y are positive integers. Then which of the following cannot be the greatest common divisor of 35x and 20y? That's our question. So first of all, what we do is when we have to find out the greatest common divisor, which is also considered as highest common factor, the first thing that we do is prime factorization of number, which means 35x can be written as 5 times 7 times x, and 20y may be written as 5 times 2 square times y. The first thing that we should notice is that 5 is part of both the numbers. So obviously highest common factor must be a multiple of 5. Now, let's go options by option, because the question is asking which of the following cannot be the greatest common divisor. So that means 4 of these options can be the greatest common divisor of these two numbers. Let's go for the first option A, which is 5. Now, we always have to keep asking the question, can 5 be the highest common divisor of these two numbers? Then you will quickly realize that answer seems like yes. But the important part in any question is that you always should bring in some values to be confident that what you're thinking is right. For example, can we imagine the values of x and y for which the highest common factor of these two numbers becomes 5? Then we can quickly think, if I assume x equal to 1 as well as y equal to 1, then the highest common factor of these two numbers will be 5. And for that reason, we can eliminate the first option. Now, we go to the second option. The second option is 5 times of x minus y. When we look at this option, our curiosity should be that can we make x minus y somehow 1? If that's possible, then 5 may be the highest common factor, because in previous option, we already have checked that 5 can be the highest common factor. In order to make this x minus y as 1, we want to think x and y two numbers which are consecutive in nature. So the first thought may start with that x equal to 2 and y equal to 1, but you will quickly realize that if I take x equal to 2, then we already have 2 as a prime factor of 20y. So the highest common factor will not be 5, instead that will become 10. So this set of values cannot be taken in order for our purpose. So we choose another set of values, that means x equal to 3 and y equal to 2. Now you realize if you take x as 3, then we don't have prime number 3 on the other side, that means in 20y. And y is equal to 2 does not make any other prime factor similar between the two numbers except 5. So this set once again eliminates this option B as well, because B now becomes 5 for this set of values, and 5 may be the highest common factor if x is 3 and y is 2. Now we go to option C. C option says 20x. We should understand what highest common factor means. Highest common factor is highest, that means biggest, common factor, common divisor, that means a number which can divide each of these numbers without leaving any remainder. So 20x, that means if 20x is a possibility, it should be able to divide each of these numbers without leaving any remainder, which means 35x by 20x should be an integer, as well as 20y over 20x should also be an integer. I see 20y over 20x can be an integer if y is equal to x. But when you see 35x over 20x, it cannot be an integer, because x can be cancelled out and 35 upon 20 is not an integer. Which means here we can infer that C option is a number which cannot be the factor of 35x. However, in order to be more confident, I am going on and then explaining why D and E options can be eliminated again. So D option says 20y. 20y means 2 square times 5y. So obviously this 20y is the factor of 20y, second number, there is no question at all. But can 20y be the factor of 35x? That means can 35x be divisible by 20y? Then the answer is yes, if x becomes equal to 2 square times y. So D option can be eliminated. And similarly, if we look at E option, which is 35x, then we can understand it's 5 times 7x. It's anyway a factor of 35x. But the question is, can it divide 20y as well? Then the answer is yes, of course it can, if the value of y is assumed to be as 7x. And that's how not only do we find the right option for ourselves, but we very confidently eliminate the other four options as well in order to be sure that our answer is perfectly fine and it's correct.